Hello everyone, and I welcome you all in Oratex. I'm going to make a whole video series on the embedded C for the beginners. And in this, it's not like that we will directly start from the embedded C. We need to take some steps. So in this whole video series, we are going to see the basic C language. We are going to develop our logic skills, and we will actually gonna write the embedded C program, and we are going to dump this program on the hardware project. So in this whole procedure, we are going to come across lots of softwares and hardwares, and I bet you after this whole video series you will be able to make your own project for your high school or your college. So let's start with it. So we are going to start with our basic C language, and in our basic C language the first topic is the header files. So these two lines are the first lines of our program, which we are going to use in our almost all the programs of the basic C. So these two lines are called the library functions. Its name is defines that the library function means it's the library of the, all the codes, means all the codes are defined inside of this library. To make you understand, I will say that suppose there is a dictionary called suppose this dictionary of English, and I'm going to use some words like happy. So in this dictionary will be you can find in this dictionary that what means by happy. So it will tell you that it's something related to the pleasure, and then it will suppose if I say apple, so it will go to the dictionary and it will find that okay, it's something, so it's a fruit which looks like something red in color. So this is the has include standard input output dot, and this h file h stands for the header file extension, and this is the conio.h, this is for the console input output dot header file instruction. Our next topic is the format specifiers. Format specifiers is used to specify the data types. These are the data types like integer, character, float, string. These are the data types. These are necessary to apply the means to allocate some memory for the variables that we will talk afterwards. Now we have to just focus on this integer. Percentage D specifies the integer, and percentage C sign specifies the character value, character data type. And the percentage F specifies the float data type, and percentage S specifies the string data type, which is the array of characters. Now, up till whatever we learned, we are going to execute in our next video. And keep watching our video, and in next video, we are going to see all these things on handling on the software. Thank you.